After COVID-19, the search engine optimization has become more strategic. And as a result, you will have to make the right strategy to rank your website organically in search engine result pages. Today in this video, I'm going to discuss about keyword mapping, which is one of the most important segments of search engine optimization. So without delay, I'm just going to discuss about why keyword mapping is important and how to do keyword mapping for your website. Before that, let me introduce myself. I'm Shobhan Ghoshal and welcome to Viva Technologies. So without delay, I'm just going to share with you why keyword mapping is still important in search engine optimization. Mainly to associate the targeted keywords to your targeted pages. You know that in every website, there are multiple pages. And in multiple pages, you will have to trigger the targeted keyword to get the targeted result. Because every website has many pages and all the pages are not same. Means are all the pages have different intention. Some pages, they are providing information. Some pages, they are conducting sales or conversion. So every page are different. As a result, you will have to embed your keywords in every pages accordingly. Number one. Number two, you can prioritize all your targeted pages like homepage. You know what is a homepage? Service page and other inner pages, including content. So when you know keyword mapping, you will definitely do these things and make good amount of traffic or generate good amount of traffic to your website, to your online platform, to your online business. You can also ask keyword mapping as a gateway because it is very close to the user intention. I think you have heard the term that content gap analysis. Now, when you are going to make a strong content gap analysis, the keyword mapping will help you. Because content gap is basically based on the user intention and the keyword mapping is focusing the user intention. So that's why it helps you in the right way. It triggers the content with the right keyword through which you can generate high conversion. Now, you may ask the question, what is keyword mapping exactly? Keyword mapping is the process of associating your targeted keywords to the dedicated pages. For example, suppose you have 10 to 15 pages website and you have different keywords for your every pages. But the architecture of the page can confirm the business goal. So keyword mapping can help there. Another important segment of keyword mapping is it is a strategy to assign the essential keywords to your targeted pages and optimize search engines and users with relevancy. Means keyword mapping helps you to identify only the relevant keywords. Suppose you are making a you are an e-commerce store and you are going to sell a product. And some keyword related to that product are irrelevant. And if you target those keywords to your website, you may lose traffic and you may lose the business potentiality. So that's why you will have to always work with the relevancy. It is the best practice to avoid cannibalization or duplication. When you will trigger on keyword mapping, it will help you to avoid the cannibalization or duplication. Because if your site produces duplicate content and duplicate pages, it will lose the potentiality and lose the ranking and lose the revenue. Now the question is, why keyword or keyword content mapping is required? Here one word I have added, and that is the content. It is very important because in website or in internet, in online platform, the content is the last word. What you have seen, whatever you have got after searching something, that is the content. It may be a video, text, article, blog, infographics, whatever it is. So you will have to know content mapping well. Keyword mapping is essential in search engine optimization because it helps the strategic search campaign. When you are going to make search campaign, it may be organic, it may be paid. You will have to focus on the strategy first because it helps mapping site structure, targeted keywords in each and individual pages, implementation of the right search engine optimization tactics of every page, along with the recommendation to run a website smoothly. So that's why the content or the keyword content mapping is required. Here is a flow. For example, if your main keyword is in the home page and if you have made a supported content in your blog section, you can trigger those. Means you can make a flow through your home page to your blog section or to your content, and it will give you the relevancy. It will help search engine and the user to rank your website in search engine result page naturally. Now the question is, what is the significant purpose of keyword mapping? Actually, the keyword mapping helps you to gain the actual traffic to your website. There are three important or the significant purposes according to me. Number one is the brand recognition, awareness and identification. Why? Because today, almost every small and medium scale industries along with the large scale industries are focusing on the branding. In keyword mapping, the branding is the most important segment, and as a result, the brand recognition, awareness and identification will be triggered through the right keyword mapping. Because here you can focus for what type of service, what type of product you are going to sell or offer. That is an important section, and that can boost your brand awareness as well. Now, number two, quality and targeted traffic, mainly the organic, because when you are triggering a particular keyword, you can definitely identify who are your targeted audience. Suppose you are selling a product or you are offering a service and you are targeting those people who needs the product or the service, that will give you more conversion. That's why I will personally suggest you to keyword mapping or focus on the keyword mapping, because only keyword mapping can help you to solve the problem in this way. Number three, improve website productivity. The productivity is the most important thing in every online journey. So when you are developing your website, you will have to make a keyword cluster, and through the keyword cluster you can use the important keywords and trigger them into the important and the relevant pages, through which you can make a strong architecture of your website and you can drive the targeted traffic to the targeted pages to help them to identify their pain point and get some solution. So that is important. That is the significance of keyword mapping. Another important segment is make a strong digital marketing goals with triggered keywords or targeted keywords. See, digital marketing goal is next to important when you are thinking about conversion. Suppose you're offering a digital marketing service. For example, Bifa Technologies is a digital marketing agency. So you are offering the same service and your targeted customer is a merchant. He wants to develop his B2B or B2C through your support. So you will have to target those keywords for the merchant which actually help him. So undoubtedly the digital marketing goals help to create a benchmark for the company or agency. You may be a company or an agency. Even it is equally applicable for blogging too. If you are a blogger, if you don't have any business like service or product selling. You can also trigger it there, because one thing is important, and that is the strong digital marketing goal brings the right productivity for you. I need a service which actually you are offering, so I will have to be attracted by your service if I would like to take your service. So that is the important section. Next, develop strong conversion funnel to smoothen buyer's journey. You know, the buyer's journey is the most important segment in every online purchase or every online section. You probably know how a conversion funnel is actually working. In a conversion funnel, you can just pinpoint the strategy and make others to purchase your product if they actually need it, and if you can solve their problem, then only they can buy the product or take the service from you. So that's why you will have to focus on the ideal conversational funnel. Here you have to concentrate on these things. Number one, type of product or service you want to sell or campaign, which is the primary focus of any conversion funnel. And if you know about keyword mapping there, you can easily trigger those keywords related to your product or your service to make a right search engine campaign. Number two, the pattern of conversion funnel you are using right now. Suppose you are focusing on content marketing or email marketing, so you will have to trigger according to that. You cannot make a generalized way to give a productivity on it. Number three, the productivity on the content you produce to build brand awareness and promotion. I have already discussed about that, but still, the brand awareness and promotion is based on your brand value. So you will have to make the brand value, and you will have to focus on the conversion through the brand awareness and brand value with the right keyword mapping. Next, the most important segment is, what are the strong conversational or conversion funnel? The strong segment of conversion funnel is based on the keyword cluster and website architecture. You know, silo architecture is there. The silo architecture is next to important in every affiliate marketing and e-commerce business. So there are different types of architectures available in the internet, and you will have to focus on the architecture according to your goal, according to your business, according to your conversion funnel. Number two, there must be a CTA or call to action section which can help you to convert your your prospect into your customer. So the call to action is based on the keyword or the right and the targeted keyword. So that's why in both the cases you will have to focus on the keyword mapping. Can only keyword mapping can help you to do that. Now, make a strong keyword bank with competitor analysis. We know that the competitor analysis is next to important in every online journey, because we are not the first one. Probably we are motivated by someone, by some company, by some website. So we will have to know who are our nearest competitors. And if you are looking for a robust and productive keyword bank, you will have to proceed with keyword research. And that is only possible if you are targeting on the competitor. But one thing you must have to focus, and that is, never target those keywords which are irrelevant to your business, to your website, to your service, to your product, to your offer. Because if you target those irrelevant keywords to your business or in your business, you will lose the profit. You will lose that targeted audience, traffic, customer, and you know, price. So that is an important segment. You will have to focus on it. Next, the implement keyword mapping with relevancy and productivity. These two words are very important. So you will have to make a strong keyword bank with relevancy. Means those keywords you will use which actually solve your purpose and the purpose of your targeted audience. That will give you the productivity. So it is clear that a keyword mapping or keyword content mapping is next to important if you want to focus, if you want to develop, if you want to grow your search engine optimization journey in the right way. In 2020, it is next to important. After COVID-19 and the coronavirus pandemic, the situation is becoming more strategic today. Means the people who are focusing on online journey, they will mostly trust on the organic result. So if you want to rank organically, you'll have to focus on the keyword mapping. Don't think that the keyword mapping is a new thing. It is one of the oldest techniques, but it is still important in 2020. If you like this video, press the like button, share it, and make some comment and ask any question if you have. Thank you for watching it.